What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and you just saw a quick unboxing on Lenovo's Slim Pro 9i laptop. So what comes inside the box? All right, so you have your safety information guide right here. You have your Lenovo Slim Pro 9i laptop setup guide. You have your power cord, and you have your power supply, which is a Type-C power supply. And it's 140 watts. So I'm gonna take the power cable and the power supply and I'm gonna hook up the cable. Awesome. Put that stuff to the side. And last but not least, we have the Lenovo Slim Pro 9i laptop. Look how beautiful this is. Weighing around 3.6 pounds with a thickness of 0.82 inches. Oh, nice, comfortable, lightweight to carry around. Awesome. All right. So let's talk about some of the ports and features on this particular laptop. All right. So if you have the laptop facing you to the point that you are able to open it up like this, on your right hand side, we have the webcam e-privacy shutter switch, your headphone mic combo jack. You have one 3.2 Gen 1 USB port. You have an additional 3.2 Gen 1 USB port, but this one right here is always on charging. And then you have your power button. All right, so we just went over the right side. Let's look at the left side. So on the left side, we have one SD card reader. We have one Thunderbolt 4 port, which acts as a display port and power delivery. We have one Type-C port, which also acts as a display port and power delivery. And then last but not least, our HDMI port. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on this particular laptop. Let's hook up the power cable. Let's open it up, right? Let's power it on and let's deep dive into the review. All right, so we just went over some of the ports and features on the Lenovo Slim Pro 9i laptop. So let's open this guy up real slow. It does have the notch at the top of the display, which we're going to talk about a little later. But let's open it up real quick. Look at that beautiful 14-inch display. All right, so like I stated earlier, the power button is located on the right-hand side. So let's press the power button to turn it on. Awesome. Now, the Slim Pro, you're able to log in using Windows Hello. Right now, I have the e-shutter turned off, but if I use the button to turn it on and I show my face, it should pick me up. Let's see. Awesome. There it goes. It logged in with no problem. Now let's talk about the trackpad on the Slim Pro. Now it works. I didn't have too many problems with this particular trackpad. It is pretty large, measuring around 5.33 inches. I did find myself hooking up a USB mouse half the time because I felt more comfortable. And with my workflow, it's much faster using a USB mouse rather than the trackpad. But when I was using it, I didn't have any problems. Now for the keyboard was really responsive. I didn't have any issues using it at all. Pretty quick, pretty seamless, no issues on that department. If you want to know the key distance between each key, it's around 0.12 inches. The keyboard is backlit. If you hold the function key and the space bar, it would turn it on. It would go one level. It would turn it off. That's about it. And then auto. Now for speakers, the speakers are located right on top of the keyboard on your right and your left hand side. The loudness that I got was pretty decent. When I was testing out the loudness, the room was around 45.5 decibels, When I raised the volume to 50%, it went up to 79.9 decibels, which was a bump up of 34.4 decibels, which was pretty high for 50%. When I raised the volume to 100% on the laptop, I got 88.6, which bumped up to 8.7 decibels, which gave me a total of 43.1 decibels on this laptop, which is pretty loud. Now let's talk about the display. The display is a beautiful display, 14 inches. It is touch screen, which I didn't find myself using it at all because it gathers a lot of smudges. The resolution is 3072 by 1920. For the brightness level, I think this is the highest right now. And this is the lowest that we could go in the brightness. And this is the highest. And this is the lowest. And let's go one more time. This is the highest. If you want to know about nits, it is around 1200 nits. Watching anything on this particular laptop was amazing because the colors are so bright and vibrant. It was just dead on great. So if you're a designer that does a lot of color matching or a videographer that does a lot of coloring, like color correction, this would be the particular laptop that you want to look into. It does have HDR. Just make sure that you plug in the power cable to utilize that feature on this laptop. Refresh rate by default, it is 60 hertz, but you are able to bump it up to 165. At the top of the 14-inch display, we have a notch, and the notch actually holds the webcam. The webcam is 5 megapixels, giving you a resolution of 2592 by 1940. The webcam itself on the video format is around 1440p, and it actually goes up to 30 frames per second. It does have a privacy guard, but it is a digital switch, which is on the right-hand side. And right now, I think I have it off. This is on, and this is off. And one more time, this is on and this is off. On the right and the left of the webcam, you have two mics, so in total of four microphones, which is awesome. I did get some raw footage using the webcam and the four microphones on this particular laptop, so let's take a look at that.
All right, guys, so this is the webcam on Lenovo's Slim Pro 9i laptop. This is raw footage. I'm not going to edit any of the audio or the video. I'm recording it within OBS Studio. As you saw, I'm setting it up earlier. The resolution and the output resolution is, I think, 3072 by 1920, 30 frames per second. It looks great within OBS. Hopefully, it looks better when I put it in post and then when you guys are watching it.
All right, so we just went over the trackpad, keyboard, the display, and the webcam on the Slim Pro 9i. Let's talk about the performance. And the performance is awesome. So if I hold the control key, shift, hit escape, fancy way to bring up the task manager. We're going to open it up a little bit. Let's go inside the performance tab. Let's go inside CPU. Let's right click on the CPU, change the graph to logical processor. All right, so this laptop is actually running a 13th gen Intel i7 core processor, which is the i7-13705H model. Base speed is around 2.40 gigahertz, one socket, 14 cores, and 20 logical processors. That is a beast. Nice. For memory, it is housing 32 gigs. You got a solid state drive, which is around a terabyte. And you have two GPUs. The first one is your Intel Iris Xe graphics card, and then for your other graphics card, you have your NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4050 laptop GPU with 6 gigs. Now, with these specifications on this particular laptop, I was able to do a lot. I was able to do editing within Premiere, Photoshop, DaVinci with some coloring, doing some media encoding. I was able to do everything on this particular laptop. Now, I did see a little bit of low performance when I was editing 4K. I just had to plug in the power adapter to do that. I saw a huge difference when I plugged in and I was able to edit 4K with no problem. Now, for heating, I did see some heating around the keyboard area and the display. The highest that I got was around 88 to 91 Fahrenheit. Now this laptop, because it has the beautiful NVIDIA GeForce RTX 4050 graphics card, I was able to do some gaming. Again, make sure you plug in that power, because if you don't, you will see a lot of lag and your frames per second would definitely go down. All right, so we just spoke about the performance on this particular laptop. Let's talk about the battery, because that's super important. You don't always want to be hardwired in with the power supply to constantly use this laptop. So I'm going to close up the task manager. I'm going to open this up. For my testing, I like to use PC Mark 10. I typically run between 3 to 4 tests. On the first test, I did modern office battery life. Now, 4 hours is super low for this particular laptop. Out of the box, never been used heavily, and I got 4 hours. So I kind of find that pretty strange. So what I did is I ran the test again. I fully charged the battery to 100% and I ran the test again. And I got a better performance time, which was around 6 hours and 15, which is not that bad. That's what I was expecting, between 6 to 7 hours of battery life, at least 7 hours or 6 hours, right? And then last but not least, I did video and I got the 7 hours that I want. Now, testing it out personally without plugging in constantly, I got between, I would say, 6.5 hours on this laptop. And it all depends on what you're doing on it. I was watching a lot of content on YouTube and Netflix and doing a lot of editing. And when I was actually editing a lot and rendering using Media Encoder, the battery time kind of decreased. All right, so let's conclude our review on the Lenovo Slim Pro 9i laptop. Now, for external monitors, you are able to hook up 3 monitors, but you definitely need to plug in a power, so you can't hook up 3 monitors. So I would say 2 monitors would be the safe bet. Now for pricing, this particular laptop, if you want these specs with the memory and the graphics card and the hard drive space of 1 terabyte, at Best Buy, retail price is around $1,900. So that's like your base right now. Overall experience on this laptop, I really had a lot of fun with it. The size is dead on. It's beautiful, super lightweight with 3.6 pounds. The thickness, 0.82 inches, which is really thin to me and really light, very comfortable to handle and carry around every day. One of the things I love about the laptop, it has the right amount of ports for me. It has 2 USBs, it has my SD card, it has 2 Type-Cs. It just has the right amount of ports and HDMI. Beautiful. The only thing that I kind of found strange that this laptop did not have was a fingerprint scanner, which is okay. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this review on Lenovo's Slim Pro 9i. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.